question number 51. So this is a very simple one. Water gas is. So water gas is also known as the syngas. And it is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. So option number 3 will be your correct answer. So moving on to the next one now, you have question number 52, which says that the consider the colors of flames of falling metals. Which of the above mentioned colors are correctly matched? So you have here all the group 2 metals, that is beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium and barium. So you should know that the beryllium and magnesium don't impart any color to the flame. So they have no color to the flame. So why they have no color to the flame? Because they have a very small size. So due to the small size, they have a very high ionization enthalpy. So the excitation energy is very high. So it does not lie in the visible region. So we don't get any color to the flame test. So the first statement is correct. And the second statement is incorrect because magnesium does not impart any color. And the golden yellow, you can remember, it is shown by the sodium metal to the flame test. And calcium is brick red, that is correct. And strontium is crimson. And barium give apple green color on flame test. So fourth is also correct and fifth is incorrect. So we have first, third and fourth that are correct. So option number 1 will be the correct answer. So moving on to the next one now, you have question number 53, which says that which of the following does not form a dimer. So you have here BH3, AlCl3, BF3 and BeCl2. So you must be knowing that the BH3 forms a very famous dimer, that is B2H6. And it has a structure like this. This is the dimer of BH3, that is B2H6. So these are the bridged hydrogens. And these are the terminal hydrogens. And similarly, AlCl3 also forms the dimer, that is Al2Cl6. And BeCl2 also forms the dimer, that is Be2Cl4, but in the vapor phase below 1200 Kelvin. In vapor phase below 1200 Kelvin. So the compound which are generally electron deficient, they form dimer to complete the electron valency. But BF3 does not form any dimer. Why? Because in BF3 there is a p-pi back bonding from the filled orbitals of fluorine to the vacant orbitals of boron. So due to the pi bonding, the BF3 is not that much electron deficient. So that's why it does not form any dimer. So I hope this is clear to you. So option number 3 will be the correct answer. So moving on to the next one now, you have question number 54, which says that what is the volume of 20 volume H2O2 solution required to get 5000 centimeter cube of oxygen at STP? So what do you mean by the 20 volume H2O2 solution? It means that if you take 1 liter of this solution, so it will liberate 20 liter of oxygen at STP. Now we have to calculate the volume of the solution to get 5000 centimeter cube of oxygen. So you can also write it like this, that 20 centimeter cube of oxygen is obtained by 1 centimeter cube of the solution. I hope this is clear to you. Now you have to find out for 5000 centimeter cube of oxygen. So you have to simply apply the unitary method. So it will be 1 by 20 into 5000. So it will come out to be 250 centimeter cube of the solution. So option number 4 will be the correct answer. So moving on to the next one now, you have question number 55. So which is related to the alkali metals. So consider the following statements when an alkali metal is dissolved in liquid ammonia. So this is a very, very important reaction whenever the alkali metals are dissolved in liquid ammonia. So suppose you have an alkali metal, that is M, which is dissolved in aqueous ammonia. So what happens is that it formed the ammoniated electrons. And due to the presence of these ammoniated electrons, the solution becomes blue in color because these electrons absorb the energy in the visible region and imparts blue color. So this color of the solution is blue, and it is also paramagnetic due to the presence of ammoniated electrons. And due to the paramagnetic nature, it will become the good conductor of electricity. First statement which says that the solution is green in color, that is wrong because the solution is blue in color. So now we have the second statement which says that the solution is pure conductor of electricity, which is also the false statement. Now we have the solution contains ammoniated electron, that is absolutely correct. So only option, that is option number 3, is the correct answer.